The Amiga is a new microconsole which emulates the original Amiga 500 and brings a raft of modern features to the table. Built around a dual-core ARM CPU, the Amiga outputs 720p game footage over HDMI with spot-on emulation and sound. Games can be run from the included microSD card or loaded from a flash stick through one of the two USB ports. PC standard mouses, keyboards and gamepads are all supported over USB. All this in a gorgeous 3D printed case. When compared to a lot of recent emulation consoles, already the Amiga is leagues ahead with a host of modern outputs as well as an Ethernet port for networking and updates. But the heart of what makes the Amiga the bee's knees is the custom floppy controller. The guys at the Amiga Project have developed their own floppy controller capable of reading, decoding, and even ripping original Amiga discs. The Amiga can read and back up your old collection of discs, which is becoming more and more important as those discs slowly knacker out. Each Amiga comes bundled with a fully legal, licensed copy of Kickstart 1.3, so all operations are above board and legal. Once booted up, the Amiga's graphical menu is sensible and no-nonsense. Browsing for games and adding custom covers is easy as long as you just have a basic knowledge of PCs. The USB stick support is just the ticket if you don't have an SD card reader or just can't be chuffed to muck about with it. Provided your USB stick is formatted to FAT or FAT32, you're off and away. As I mentioned before, the Amiga OS has been optimized for that ARM CPU, which gives us a perfect upscaled 720p output and perfect sound. The video output can be enhanced with post effects, which is grand for getting the look of that old telly that some of those retro gamers are fond of. The Amiga also supports save states, which is a godsend because a lot of Amiga games can be a tad hard. Gameplay, from what I've seen, is tickety-boo. Loading times can be sped up and the only slowdown or drop frames I've witnessed is in line with the original machine. Gamepad support is brilliant. I've tried every USB controller I could find, including the awesome Jab NES pad from Retro Fighters. Everything works with this thing. There's also a virtual keyboard and mouse, so everything can be controlled from a joypad. It's just a little bit dodgy, in honesty. I mean, it's great if you need to navigate the menus, but don't try and play UFO with a joypad. The Amiga emulates an Amiga 500 with 1 meg of RAM, but the latest update has added a mild bit of AGA support, which is top draw for Amiga fans, because this now adds the Amiga 1200 library to the supported games list. Support is a bit wonky at the moment, but updates are always coming out. Besides, the Amiga is sold as an A500, so there's no grounds to whinge about it not having full A1200 support. Speaking of updates, the unit can self-update over the included Ethernet port, or you can do it manually by adding the update file to the SD card. If all of this wasn't reason enough to go out and buy one, booting an Amiga without the microSD card in it boots it into Android 4.2. With this dual boot feature, you could load further emulators and more ROMs onto it. You could run Kodi. I mean, you can do anything you want with an Android device, in addition to it also being an Amiga. If you're serious about Amiga gaming or just curious about retro computers, the Amiga is a fabulous purchase and it's worth every penny of the €120 price tag. That's about what the Spectrum Vega cost at launch, and this comes with about 1000% more features. The €170 floppy drive unit is a great purchase for the Amiga aficionado who wants to salvage their floppies before Father Time buggers them up for good. Check out amigaproject.com for support. There is a link in the description. Updates and purchasing is all there on the website. Please subscribe to the Game Show for more old PC gaming videos.